There is a new partnership between veterans and the VA. It's called the Million Veteran Program, or MVP. MVP studies the genetics of blood samples given by veterans to find new ways of preventing and treating illnesses in veterans and the general population. It is VA's goal to get 1 million veterans to volunteer for this program.
I think the most important thing that it will do is look at what the genes do to cause diseases and then develop drugs and other interventions to treat those diseases.
Why do some people live longer than others? What's the cause of certain diseases like cancer and cardiovascular disease, diseases that are important and common to all of us? How do medicines work better in some patients than others? And can we personalize the care of a given patient by looking at their genes and figuring out what's the best medicine for a given patient?
The MVP will answer questions such as, why does treatment work well for some veterans but not for others? Why are some veterans at a greater risk for developing an illness? And how can we prevent certain illnesses in the first place?
So far, almost 200,000 people have completed the survey that we send out when we invite veterans to participate. Over 118,000 have agreed to enroll and contributed a blood specimen. Tens of thousands have appointments coming up in the near future to contribute. And so we're well on track to achieving our goal in 5 to 7 years.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gingado. Very nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Thank you so much.
Enrolling in the program was very, very simple. I contacted the program manager. I made an appointment to come in.
Oh, I have a question.
Please.
We had a blood draw, and I gave them my contact information.
Our genes sort of tell us how we're related to other members of the military.
There's not too much work you have to do. You fill out informed consent, fill out a few questionnaires, give a blood sample, and that's it.
All right, so you're gonna fill a little stick.
What makes it special is its VA focus. The idea that our veterans have served our country, and while they certainly come down with health conditions that non-veterans get, they also have conditions that seem to be overrepresented among their rank and file.
When veterans agree to participate in the program, we assure them that their information is going to be kept confidential. We do that by barcoding with an identifier that is not related to the social security number, phone number, or name.
Yeah, well, you know, we're bringing 10 more sites on.
I know.
It's in a very exciting time, and this is earth-shattering or groundbreaking. We are definitely breaking new ground. And the VA is really an ideal place to do this because we have a willing veteran population.
People with osteoarthritis, when they climb stairs, they lean their trunk forward more in order to better get up the stairs. And we were looking to see if we can use that as a functional test.
They're totally altruistic. They have not been told it will help them personally. It may or it may not.
Okay, the data looks good.
But they've been told it will help others, and they do it for that reason.
It's going to end up on the floor.
I contributed to this program for a number of reasons. One being, I'm a 51-year-old female combat veteran, and there's not too many of us out there. So I wanted to get my information on record in that medical database.
Did you have any questions?
I know how important guardian's data is, and I said, if I could help in any way possible, I'd be more than happy to.
If you are a veteran receiving care in the VA healthcare system and would like to become an MVP volunteer, please call toll-free 866-441-6075 or visit us at www.research.va.gov/MVP.